People, 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 we are here again. We are looking at the good old windblows, or as EB calls it, or windows. I just want to talk a little bit about, well, this thing right here. I hear both Mac people, Linux people, BSD people, Haiku people, non-people, humanoid people, people that do things on hub sites, and all kind of people saying that Windows is slow. It's a behemoth, it's bloated, it's more bloated than I am, it's really slow, all of these kind of things. Is Windows really that slow? So I kind of a little bit of how I do my video. So if you see a Windows video, that's done like this. And when I say like this, it's done on systems like this here. It says here 6-core system. You can see it's a Ryzen 5 7600X, but I only have 4 cores. Because it's a VM, you know, if you go down here, you can see it's the VirtualBox. I've been dabbling between VirtualBox and VMware Fusion. All my machines, Linux, Windows, that you've seen on my channel have been, oh well, my videos, not machines, have been recorded on virtual machines running 4 cores and between 4 and 8 gigabytes. The last 2 years, it's been 8 gigabytes, both Windows and Linux. So I'm kind of a little bit in that nature of, is Windows really that slow? You see, I'm opening up some massively intensive programs here, and I'm not joking. Browsers nowadays, if you have a shit ton of extensions on it, oops, I was using Adblock on that one. You know, if you have a shit ton of extensions open, or apps open, or when I say apps, I mean tabs open, and blah, blah, blah. And you see all of this here. This takes a lot of resources. If you go in here and we look at the resource thing, Medusky, I can have it up there. You can see it's creeping up in RAM and the page file. I was about to say pegging for the win. You know, and it's like that on any system. You know, like Linux, Windows, BSDs and whatnot, and then you go on and you do a little bit of this, a little bit of that, you open up a side panel, you know, you open up the WinUI 3 gallery to look a little bit here at, let's say, let's do some media, we want to do some image presentation, we want to see the code, this is how you do that, let's go into basic inputs, we want to do a button, let's look at some code here. Yeah, let's look at some more code here. Does this seem slow to you guys and girls? Let's see. Let's go in here and do some styling. Let's do some acrylic process. Let's mess around with it here. Let's change that to red, that to yellow. See some source code here. Like, it's almost identical to my full-blown machine that has 32 gigs of RAM and 12 cores. The only time where I see a difference is when I'm compiling a package. When I'm compiling, or not compiling, but packets are a C# program, you know, making a installable package, you know, where you are taxing out the CPU 100%. Yes, having more cores is going to help you. If you are gaming, well, what is my graphic card? I don't really have one because it's the built-in VirtualBox graphic card. So yeah, I can probably play Solitaire and shit like that. But that's about it. But these machines here, my VMs, are not for gaming. At work, I have a 6-core system with, I think, is it 16 gigs of RAM or something like that? That is my testing, development, research, troubleshooting, network administration, infrastructure administration, PC, and it's doing great. It's doing really, really well, and it's running Windows 11 Professional. I don't sit and be like, let's wait for this task to be done. I never sit and wait for that. The only thing I wait for is that I'm in, like, I've been thrown down in the corner, or not in the corner, but further down in the not office, it's a production hall, but I'm kind of like in the middle towards the end of it, and there's no like Ethernet cable, so I have Wi-Fi, and it sometimes is a little bit iffy. That's the only thing I'm waiting for, is sometimes the Wi-Fi, if there's a lot of traffic, a lot of backing up going on and stuff like that, if you have quite a few Wi-Fi equipment plugged into the Wi-Fi, so it can be not oversaturated, but I can lose, you know, some strength in the signals once in a while. That's the only thing I'm waiting for. For most daily tasks that you are going to do, you know, going on to the main IMSA webs, let's see what this is. I have no fucking idea what this this update have, but yeah, anyway, rounded CB, so this is the thing I have down here. What most people are doing on their computer, like browsing, social media, consumption, and stuff like that, 4 cores and 8 gigs of RAM is not going to hinder most of their stuff. If you have a 6-core and 8 plus gigs of RAM, you probably have no issues doing the work tasks that the vast majority of people are doing. If you are a coder, if you are a developer, if you are a research assistant, if you are a scientist, if you are a computer AI scientist, if you are a research and development in big data, machine learning, AI and stuff like that, now we're talking something different. Now you really need these two things here. What am I trying to say here is that, no, Windows is not slow. Windows is probably slower than, let's say, Linux, FreeBSD, and Heiko, if you are running this here at 100% 24/7. Go in and do I have Cinebench? I think it's even in the store, so let's go and install that just for fun here. You see, I'm downloading Cinebench, and while that's doing, we can still go in here and we can open up some other shit. Let's open up, I don't know. Let's look at, I have no for Airbus. What's Airbus into nowadays? Some things with planes, of course, Airbus, you know, and we are still downloading. We can opening it up. We're getting Cinebench. Yes, I accept. We can run. Let's just run a test. And we don't need to have that maximized. You may hear my fans kicks off a little bit. You see, if you're running like this here, 24/7, and you can see even still, I'm maxing out my 4-core, 8 gigs, so I can't minimize this much more. I can still use the system. I do feel a slight amount of slogginess right now. I will agree with that, or will acknowledge that. It's a little bit sluggish, but you can see, and it's slow. It's 4 cores running at 5.2 plus gigahertz right now, only on 4 cores. But I can still do normal shit. Hey people, welcome back, and because I am the smartest fucking tech guy in the world, OBS craps itself. Windows is not slow. Okay, Windows is not bloated. Windows run amazingly well on 4-core, 8 gig of RAM. If anyone has a better screen recording software, please let me know. That don't cost like $3,000 a month, because I'm so fed up with OBS. It's always giving me issues. Always getting me issues. I may even go over to fucking Streamlabs, because it seems to be way more stable. But anyway, that's a video for another time. What I hope this video was showing you is that Windows is not slow. Windows is not bloated. Windows is not unusable on all this hardware. It's actually really comparable. It's actually really usable. So I hope this debugged that a little bit, and I need to be more aware of not trying to benchmark a fucking computer while I'm doing recording. That's not a big brain move. See you all later. Bye bye.